The Foundation's Official Handbook, 3rd Edition. Spatial, Temporal, and Dimensional Anomalies. Page 247, Chapter 24. Erratic Transdimensional Travel. So you've been trapped in a pocket dimension. What now? You've been transported to an area isolated between time and space. What now? Well, the first step is to examine your surroundings for possible exits and dangers. If it is too dark to see, use your mobile device as a light source. If you happen to spot a doorway, window, archway, or any other form of pathway, and you cannot see what is on the other side, begin moving in the direction of the possible exit. If you happen to spot a creature, living light, sentient shadows, or sentient object of an aggressive nature, don't panic. The inhabitants of the pocket dimension you have entered most likely view you as an intruder or a source of nutrition, and should be treated in the same way you would treat encountering a hungry bear, with extreme caution and a fight-or-flight mindset. Has the aggressive creature spotted you? If so, begin moving slowly away from the creature, and if not, also start to slowly move away from the creature. If the creature in question notices this action and begins to walk or hover towards you, do not let it near you, as it may attempt to attack, consume, melt, devour, obliterate, and/or place a nest for its young within your chest cavity. Please note that this textbook doubles as an excellent source of information and a blunt weapon due to the size and weight of the piece of educational literature. While attempting to stealthily assault the creature you've encountered as possible, it is incredibly likely that this event will result in your death, serious injury, or forced immortality in a non-responsive state. Out of the last 20 survivors of erratic transdimensional travel to a pocket dimension, 19 out of 20 agree that attacking a possibly godlike entity with a textbook is a bad idea. And the 20th is currently recovering following their unfortunate re-entry inside a trash compactor. If you survive your time in a pocket dimension and discover an exit, please note that your inevitable re-entry into our dimension appears random and you may suffer from any of the following: re-entry under a body of water, re-entry within an object, re-entry into the stratosphere, re-entry into the wild, re-entry onto highways, railways, subway tracks, and/or tarmacs, re-entry into another person or organism. If you've survived any of these unfortunate re-entries, please alert your nearest Foundational Dimensional Research Station, the FDRS, for extraction and debriefing. If you did not survive, alerting your nearest FDRS is unnecessary and should be avoided. If you are unsure of your current state of being, please flip to page 272 of this handbook, Existing and Why It is Important to Productivity, for more information.